Well, hey, yesterday, Thursday, I was up at the University of Central Florida for their annual accounting conference. In the past couple of years, it's been a virtual conference, but they were back live. Oh, it was so great to be in front of a live audience again, showing people what's new in Excel. Because when you're there live, you can see people react like, oh yeah, that's a great idea. And this question today is from Willie, who was at the conference. Willie has a VLOOKUP problem, and he saw the text before function, which is in Insider's Fast right now. He's like, oh, I wonder if that would solve my problem. And at the time, I said, oh, it should be simple. But it turns out it's not as simple as I thought. Let's take a look. All right, so Willie has a vendor database that he's downloading that has the name of the vendor, a space, a dash, a space, and then some sort of a URL. And he wondered if he could use TEXTBEFORE to get everything before the dash. And I thought, yep, that should work. And at first, I had the wrong idea. I thought that the data that he was downloading was over here where he had to do the VLOOKUP from, right? And so you have a lookup table over here that just says Bellows College, and over here it might say Bellows College space dash space and then some URL out there, right? So in that case, it was pretty simple. We're gonna do a VLOOKUP. Instead of looking up A2, we do the TEXTBEFORE. Now you have to be really careful here because it's space dash, and we don't want to insert a trailing space, which you could easily do if you just did text before the dash. So I want to do text before in quotes space dash, and then the rest of the VLOOKUP stays the same from M to O. We want the second column and a zero or false at the end for an exact match, and double click to copy that down. But then when I reread Willie's question, I realized it's the lookup table that has the extra data. So over here in his regular data, he just has the company name or the vendor name, but over here in the lookup table, he's downloading this from, he said, a credit card app. It has the vendor space dash space and then the URL. All right, so now this is gonna force us to switch from VLOOKUP to XLOOKUP, but that's okay. All right, so the formula that I've written here, XLOOKUP, we're gonna look up that company name. And then where are we gonna look? Well, we're gonna do the text before of that entire column, M2 to M41, looking for everything before the space dash. And then in this case, I'm gonna return the limit, which is over here in O. And that worked great. I'm like, oh, Willie, yeah, this is gonna be perfect. You're gonna love it as soon as you can get your company to upgrade you to Insider's Fast so you have the new text before function. But then, as I was preparing to record this video, I always copy the question and put it here on the question sheet, and one word caught me. He says, my issue is that the vendor name sometimes comes with additional info at the end, like Condoso space dash space cadet.biz. Sometimes, that complicates things dramatically. All right, so here's the same formula, the first formula where we have the extra dash over here in column A. And as I copied that down, I started to get a lot of NAs, and the NAs are happening where we don't have a dash. And unfortunately, that's a problem with text before. I hope before it gets to general availability that Joe McDade and the Excel team decides to change this. But right now, if we're looking for text before the dash and there is no dash, they return the NA error. I would think it would make more sense just to return the entire text. No dash there, just give me the whole text. So it's very tempting, because we're getting an NA error, to deal with this using if NA. So if we get an NA, then give me A2. Otherwise, give me the text before A2, everything before the space dash. But I'm gonna propose something different. And it's gonna become really important in the next example where we're doing the XLOOKUP and doing a text before on many items. I'm going to propose using text before A2 ampersand space dash, right? So what's that going to do? Here with Lamna Healthcare Company, I'm going to get Lamna Healthcare Company space dash space worry.com space dash, right? But it doesn't matter, because the text before is going to get rid of everything before the dash. But here in Graphic Design Institute, where there is no space dash, I'm going to force a space dash to be there, and then the text before will get rid of it. And that little change would allow me to prevent the whole NA. So A2 ampersand quote space dash end quote, like that, double click and copy it down.
All right. Now, in reality, either of these would be okay here. There's no issue. The problem, though, is when we have to do the XLOOKUP. Right? So with the XLOOKUP, we're going to get errors when there's not a dash over here, like all these ones in red are going to generate NA errors. And I think it's easier with the text before to say, I'm going to take all of these items in M2 to M41. I'm going to concatenate them ampersand with space dash end quote. And then it starts to work. All right. So at first it seemed really simple, but there's things that will be the gotchas. The other gotcha that I worried about is I used to have a data set where RotoRooter with a dash, R-O-T-O dash rooter, was in the data, and that dash could be a problem. But when I went back and looked, it wasn't Roto space dash, it was just dash, so I escaped that bullet. Still, you need to be careful in case some of the vendors, for some weird reason, already have a dash, and then the credit card company is adding a second space dash space, then you might have to handle those in some other way. You know, I made a big deal back in 2019 that I wasn't going to be traveling anymore and getting off the road. University of Central Florida, my new favorite football team, they are just 48 minutes from my house. I made a joke, I'll do any live seminars as long as it's within a 49-minute drive. It was so nice, no airplanes, and boy, it was just great to be back in front of a live audience. I have several podcasts lined up with ideas or questions that came from this live event. Thanks to Professor Sean Dennis for organizing this and inviting me. I had just a great time there at the University of Central Florida. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.